Last weekend, I was lucky enough to visit all the Christmas markets in Cologne with our friends. Cologne is home to some of the most beautiful and festive Christmas markets in Germany, and I'm so glad that I got to visit. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know for your visit to Cologne, including what markets you should visit, the order that you should visit them in, and what other must-knows to help you make the most of your time in Cologne. So let's get started. The most famous Christmas market is the Cathedral Market. I would recommend visiting the Cathedral Market first if you can. Because it's right next to the Cologne Cathedral, if you go there during the day, you'll get to enjoy the beautiful and famous backdrop of the cathedral in its full glory. Also, because it's right next to the cathedral and also opposite the Cologne train station, it is unfortunately the most touristy market and does get very packed later in the day. The earlier that you visit, the more you're going to be able to enjoy the market at your own pace. The next market that you should definitely visit is the Haus Gnomes Winter Market. This market is only a 10-minute walk away from the Cologne Cathedral and was definitely a major highlight for us. There's a lot to see here, and the market is so big that it's actually split into two separate sections, the Hue Market and the Alter Market. There is also an ice skating rink and an ice curling rink. And one tip is that if you do want to go ice curling, you need to reserve a spot beforehand as it can get booked out. When you're done at the Gnomes Market, I would recommend you walk alongside the Rhine River for another 10 minutes and you'll find yourself at the Harbour Market. This is not a very big market, but has a very fun nautical theme. I also think that this market is nice to visit during the day because that way you can enjoy a nice view of the river while strolling through the market stalls. By this time, the sun is probably going to be setting, which is perfect for you to move on to the Angels Market. The Angels Market is the oldest market in Cologne and only a 20-minute stroll from the Harbour Market. The first thing you'll notice when you arrive at this market are the magical bright stars hanging in the trees. It's absolutely beautiful and is also why I recommend visiting this market at night, because that way you can enjoy the decorations to their fullest. For a change of scenery, we then walked another 10 minutes to the Hevenew Market. This is the LGBT Christmas market of Cologne and has a totally different festive vibe from the other Christmas markets. It's definitely a market that comes alive at night, and while it isn't very big, it's a lot of fun with live music and plenty of delicious food to choose from. When you've finished having a dance and eating all the delicious food, you should head over to the St. Nicholas Market. The St. Nicholas Market is only 3 minutes away from the Hevenew Market and is right next to the Hahnen Gate, a 13th century gate from Cologne's former medieval city walls. Of all the markets that we visited, the St. Nicholas Market was my absolute favorite. There were just fewer tourists when we were there, and yes, it is a little bit smaller than the Cathedral Market and the Gnome Market, but I just loved the calm and more local vibe of this place. If you still have energy and some spare time to visit one more market, then head on over to the Stadtgarten Market. This is only a 15-minute walk away from the St. Nicholas Market and is very unique because it is, as the name suggests, in a garden. This market reminded me of summer music festivals back in Australia and just has a very chilled out vibe. Now let's move on to what food and drinks to order. So no doubt you've heard of Glühwein. It is a hot spiced wine which can be red wine, it can also be white, rosé, or even customized to the liquor of your choice. Each market will serve its Glühwein or mulled wine in its own unique mug design. You pay a deposit on the mug when ordering your drinks, and if you like the mug, then you can keep it. If you don't want to keep the mug, you can just return it to the bar and then get your deposit back. Easy as that. If you want to up the ante, you can also get a type of Glühwein served with a sugar cube on top that has been soaked in rum and is then set on fire. If you want a non-alcoholic option, you'll be pleased to know that every market also sells an alcohol-free version of Glühwein called Kinderpunsch. It is best described as a warm and cinnamon-spiced black currant juice, or I tried something that was more like a pear juice. Germans are famous for their sausages, and pretty much anywhere you go, there will be a Wurst sausage stand. The sausage to bread ratio is a little bit ridiculous, but that is part of the fun. The best one I tried was a Krakowurst, which is a type of Polish sausage and was really good. I also tried a type of potato pancake, which is best described as an enlarged hash brown. At the markets, you'll often see this served with applesauce, which I know sounds very strange, but trust me, the combination is good. Truth be told, I didn't try as much food as I thought I would, not because it wasn't good, but because I got way too full too quickly. There are so many food recommendations on the internet, like the raclette and the gingerbread, but my tip would just be to eat whatever looks interesting to you. I'm sorry to say that there aren't many suitable options at the market for you if you are vegan. I'm mostly plant-based, but not a strict vegan, which was lucky because I really didn't find too many things that were 100% vegan. If you are vegan, then I suggest you eat your main meals outside of the market. And now onto some other must-know tips to help you make the most of your time in Cologne. The first tip is to take some cash with you. A lot of the market stalls do not accept card. There are some ATMs dotted around the markets though if you do run out of cash. The opening hours do vary between the markets. Some are open a bit earlier and others are open a little bit later in the day. So make sure you take a look at the official websites of each market so that you can plan ahead. All the markets do close at 10 p.m. I would also recommend visiting the Cologne Cathedral. At 157 meters tall, this cathedral is the second tallest church in Europe and the third tallest church in the world. It is an incredible sight to behold. Another thing that I learned from my time in Cologne is that it's really important to wear a warm but also a waterproof jacket. At this time of the year, there is a higher chance of rain, and unfortunately, there weren't many undercover areas at the markets. It rained quite a lot on Sunday when we were there, and if I didn't have my waterproof jacket, I would have been soaking wet. Finally, if you are traveling in a group and by train, I would recommend trying to get a private room. Yes, I know that sounds like a first class passenger thing, but we were second class passengers and you are totally able to sit inside one of those rooms as well. And we didn't have to reserve a space in advance. The best thing about these rooms is that you can close the door fully, which in these days not only feels more COVID safe, but it also meant that we had full privacy and plenty of space for our baggage and coats. So that's it. Those are all my tips for Cologne, and I hope that got you excited about visiting the markets. If you found this video helpful, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and make sure you hit the subscribe button down below if you want to watch more videos like these. Let me know in the comments as well if you have visited the Cologne Christmas markets before, and if you have, please tell me what was your favorite market. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.